the 21-year-old compact Armada, today I want to present to you, it's in fact not a celebration yet, in fact this is a laptop, a Pentium 4 laptop, so I think this thing comes from, help me out, 1999 or so, something like that. But here it is, it's a dual laptop. Really, I got this from a friend one day. In fact, I went to him to buy a video card. So I came home. Also, it had no adapter. The guy had the adapter there, but it was from some other computer. And he tested it out, it never went on. So I came home and I got myself one of my old adapters. And I popped it in here. You can see, this is the dual. Let me see what the exact model is. It's the N24-3S1, I think. It says model number. In fact, there is little to find. Rechargeable battery. Yeah, I think this is it, peeps. You see that? This is the name. It's a dual personal computer, model number N24-3S1. It came, of course, with a Windows XP Professional, so that's how I got my license. And in fact, what can we still do with it? If we know that we can do all sorts of fantastic things with our little friend there at the back, that in fact is now my 432 player, and it's playing all these kind of mixes that I created and converted to 432 hertz. It's playing them nice and sweet on the background over, of course, the bucket speakers that I once created also in a video. All right, so I made a video of this laptop a while ago already, but I never made a good review to show you what this thing has. So let's do that just for the record. Here we can put in the power. I think here we can, what is this? This looks like how you call these outputs? Not VGA, I think it's called SVGA output here. The little round cable that you can connect to your TV. Here we can put in a network card. We have one USB port, but we also have, if I can see it very well, what is this thing? No, it's not. It looks like a FireWire port. This little thing here. You know those cams that had this connection, so you could connect them to, in fact, to the computer, and then with Windows Movie Maker, you could then copy the whole tape one on one to the computer to go and edit it then, and you know. So I think that is this port here. At the back, we have a fan that we can kind of reach very well thought of here. Yeah? 1, 2, 3 screws. Pull it out and you get into the fan and you can clean it out completely. Very important for these old machines because they are also probably a little low on the paste that you must put on the processor in the cooling paste. So you must make sure that they don't get too hot. Otherwise, you know, make sure you replace them, put some fresh paste, etc. But if you're not gonna do that, make sure that it's not having any dust. This thing can run Windows XP. It can also run Windows 7 Lite version, and of course Vista Lite. I think it can. It should also be able to run the Pentium 4. It's not a Pentium 3, and it can also run the Apple operating system Mac OS 10.5.8. I had it installed on here. I'm not even sure what is installed on here at this moment. I remember that it had a very small hard drive, so I'm gonna probably insert the IDE drive from my friend that I got from Pijsa, remember? The one that also gave me the 40 gigabyte drive for this beautiful Armada 1750 behind me. But that in a that a little bit later, because what we first gonna do, we're gonna give this thing a paint job, because in fact it looks a little bit bad. It has a big scratch here. I think that scratch came from whatever if I remove the sticker nice, I could pop it to something else. So we're gonna clean it a bit and we're gonna spray paint it, of course the same color. Now if we're gonna take a look at the scratch, we can see that the scratch is going straight over the metal plated jewel sign, so it was also a little bit loosened. I glued it again with very strong glue. So what I think what we're gonna do here is also a big scratch, see that? We're gonna first put some primer on these parts, but first we're gonna clean this thing with white thinner. So let's get started. I just got a piece of cardboard. I'm gonna use it to protect, so we don't have to use masking tape and all these things. Only thing what we need to do, put this like that. Let's get some white spirit. We call it turpentine. It will remove all the dirt that you could not remove with anything else. You also need a good cloth. Best cloth in the world. Make sure to feel good if it's nice and clean. Some dirt. Oh, there was a little hole. Let's dry it. This looks good. So we need to work on these scratches here. Primer. Make sure it is still enough. We go over them scratches. Fill them up with primer. Scratches. Be careful with this just want to do the scratches so they're kind of gone. Let's try. Be careful. Okay, we take a look at the dried up primer and we see that all the scratches are kind of gone. The primer filled it kind of up, and what I'm gonna do now is, because this is really nice and dry, I'm gonna take my microfiber cloth and just go over, kind of polish the primer. You know, the microfiber cloth is also kind of a polish towel. Okie doke, after the first coat of primer, I see that some scratches are still visible, so I'm just gonna spray a little bit more of the primer on these scratches. And in fact, that is going really nice now, because now they are kinda completely gone. So, yeah, that's what we want, right? Normally I would do the whole thing, one or two coats with primer, and that gives best results, you know, but I'm kinda low on primer today. We take some time to look at the paint. This is it from the Action. $1.99 a can. It's about the good color. Used it before. It's just fine. Okay, it looks dry to me. Nice. Scratches are gone. I don't see no scratch anymore. I think this is just fine, yo. I'm not gonna sell it off, but I'm gonna wipe it off with a microfiber cloth. See what's gonna happen. It's not coming off, that's good. So in fact, we're making it nice and smooth. Great. It's kind of silver, eh? Gonna let it dry now. Hope we don't get no dust on it. No little flies. We must let it dry. It dried kinda nice. Is it dry? Yes, it is. We also have some little dust. We had a little fly that lost his life, unfortunately. But the scratches are gone. Scratches are gone. So let's go ahead one more coat. Then we're gonna leave it like that. That's it. Put it inside. I just put it here, and I'm gonna let it dry. Let it dry really nice. It's looking really good. So the scratches are gone, and the primer did a fantastic job. So when this is dry, we're gonna take a look at what it is and what we can do with it. Now we're just gonna let it dry real nice. And we should finish it with a glossy coat, officially. But I'm not sure if I have. It's dry. Looks good. Sure could use some glossy, though. sure could use a glossy coat. Normally I always finish it with a glossy coat. But I'm out of glossy, I must buy. So what I'm gonna do instead, I'm just gonna go with the cloth and slightly go over it. Because this thing is also a sort of, it has power, huh? This cloth. This cloth is a special cloth. It's very special. And just polish it. And it's good for another 2 years now. Open it. Boom. You did not mess anything up. The sides were still looking good, so they did not need any painting. It was pure the back here. And maybe, you know, to do it really good, we should maybe one more time give it primer. You see the scratch, it's gone, but it's, you can see that there was a scratch there. So maybe we should do it even better, but not today. Now we're gonna look what's on this machine. Okay, I just turned it on. So let's see what's gonna happen. I hear something. Grr, grr, grr. Something is booting. I have no idea what I installed on this thing like 2 years ago. Oh yeah, I was telling you, when I got the laptop was not going on. But there is a little lock here. And when it's locked, you can do whatever you want, it's not gonna go on. So then I just turned it on. And then, boom, it worked. Ah, we have Ubuntu Mate on this thing. Okay, nice. And personally, I think we should probably install something like Vista Lite or so, one of my Maxi Lite versions, or we could go for a Windows 7 Lite version. This thing will never be connected to the internet, so probably it should work just fine. So let's kill the beats and let's get started. Okay, we're gonna kill the beats. Oh, that is so ungrateful, eh? And then I will have to take a look here at the CD-ROM, because I heard that there was something inside. I think I need this button here. Come out. Yeah, we got it. Okay, then I'm gonna turn you off again. Boom. Okay, I also have my lamp connected to the thing, eh? My glass lamp. Remember that we created that one day, long time ago. So now we need to find a good CD for our journey. Windows Vista Ultra Light. Unfortunately, this CD doesn't look that good. I hope we get no problems. Okay, let's boot up Vista Ultra Light. Booting up. And in fact, I should use a USB stick to boot. All these drivers that I had collected
create
yes, working drivers.
But
really,
we're not gonna waste no time on that. We just gonna start up
even further
and let the thing boot.
I was like,
and when this is done, I'm gonna get back to you.
I know that.
Okie doke, there we are. In the next screen, of course, we're gonna do an advanced install. We cannot upgrade. So what we're gonna do, in fact, is very simple. We're gonna do a custom install, delete all the drives, and then use the one and only drive in this machine, a 30 gigabyte drive, to install Windows Vista Lite. Okie doke, here we're just gonna hit next, install now. Gonna let it load. It's taking a little. Okay, up here we can insert our key, but we can also do that later. I'm gonna kinda do it later. Just hit no, it's kinda confusing here. And sorry for the white out screen. So there we go, we hit next. And we're gonna do a custom install. We can only do that, we cannot do an upgrade. There we go. Hit the little advance in the corner there and delete all the partitions that you see. After that, hit next. And the system will be formatted and the new system will be installed. Until the next screen, I'll get back to you. Okie doke, all files are copied and we're rebooting the system. The system will continue with the installation. At this point, you can remove the DVD or the USB stick, whatever you're using. Remove it, because it won't be needed anymore. All the files are copied to the system and the installing will continue from there. Okay peeps, last reboot. This should bring us straight to the desktop. And that's great. We have a light version of Vista installed. I will still have to activate it and still do some little things on it. I think we will have to install the sound driver. The sound driver will not be installed, but I know now what sound driver I need. I need the 7020 SIS AC 97 sound card. That's or 96, what is it? AC97, yeah, of course, 97 sound card that is in this thing. And in fact, it's very important to know that because Windows XP is not installing it automatically, and I think Vista will also not install it automatically, so we will have to go download that file. It's available at Softpedia, so that is kind of cool. You can find the driver straight up there. It's a small file and you can install it and then it will work. Okay, so that's kind of cool. Okay, here I'm gonna set up the system and we're set it up and soon we will be in the desktop. Okie doke peeps, we are in the desktop. Gonna get some icons on my desktop. Yeah, I'm kind of used to that, so I can find my way really fast in the system. So let's see what we can do about the sound, because sound is not installed as we can find out now, and let's see if we can fix that.
And here it is. But which one do I need? The R270. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get what is it called again? Oh my god, my cousin was always telling me about this and I always had it, because I don't want to install this driver like this. I'm not sure about this driver. Because it didn't work in XP. So why should it work in under? Let's try it. We're just gonna try it. This is the 274. Let's see what it's gonna say. You know, war makes no, it makes no sense. It destroys everything that is beautiful. It destroys love, the belief in love. You know what that means? If we all lose belief in love, this will be an evil place to be, this whole earth. Really? I don't see nothing running. I don't know what it's talking about. I'm gonna copy it to the desktop. Oh, there it goes. Don't worry. Let me see what it did not install. Okay, this one should do some dancing soon. What is it saying? Next. No driver was supported in this driver package. Okay. So Vista is telling me that I'm using the wrong driver. That's a good start, right? So at least we don't install the wrong driver. How about the A406? There is a whole list of AC97 drivers. And I think this one was built under SIS. SIS. Starting the install shield. I mean, like, it's great that the screen driver is found, and the display driver, that is the SIS 650, 650, 651, M650. So this thing also has a SIS drive, so probably this is also not good. Let me see what it's gonna say. It should also say if that is not good. Next. RTKFAC.sys not found. Okay, so at least I know that these are the wrong drivers. Beautiful. Alright, so we go to multimedia audio controller, reinstall driver. Can you see anything? Browse my computer for drivers. eyebrows. And let's go to my USB stick here. And then I should have a folder called, it can find itself there. Search. Installing driver software, peeps. I think I found it. It's installing. At least Vista is telling us that the wrong drivers are not good. So good chance. Sound is installed. Sys 7012. It's playing. We have sound. Oh, okay. Okay then, peeps. Ta-da. So it was the 7012. So remember that.
Reason why I sound so happy? Well, I installed drivers that installed just fine. Also in the device manager, it showed all was good, no exclamation mark, but there was no sound coming out of the speakers. So that was kind of crazy. So I'm glad that I found the right driver. It's the one for the Sys chipset, and it's the 7020 AC 97 driver that you need, and you can download it at Softpedia. Alrighty, it's time to install Foobar 2000 now, so let's go ahead and install it, because I really want to see how this software will play my music. I heard many great things, stories about it. So I want to hear it for myself, and we're not gonna install it yet or open it yet. We installed it. Now we're gonna copy the DLL file, and we're gonna go to program files, and we're gonna look for Foobar. Open the first folder and paste it into the other DLL files. So now we're gonna see if the thing opens.
It works fine, you see? So it had to do with the XP Lite. So let me load the file, open. My computer here. And dream the reggae. Okay, it's playing at 44.1 kilohertz. Now we're gonna change that. We go to file and then to preferences. We go to playback and then to DSP manager, and up here we're gonna go for the one that the sound touch. We double click it and then configure, and then pitch adjust. Yeah, semi tones minus 1.8. So that is very hard to do. How can I? Oh, probably like this. You see that? With the arrow, you must be at 1 minus 1.8.1. You see that? And then you hit OK. And that's it. Apply. OK. So now every song that you're gonna play is gonna play at that frequency. You hear that? So every song that you load in this player will play with that rate, minus 1.81. Okay, so this is working. It has a nice sound. It's not so loud as the compact, eh? But now we have this 432 Hz player fixed. We can easily now play music at 432 Hz. What we're also gonna do is we're gonna install K-Lite Mega Codec Pack, because this is a stronger computer. This thing can play videos. We say advanced. Next, up here we select profile, lots of stuff, next, media player classic or Windows media player. You can choose which one you want to use. I'm gonna go for the classic. We're gonna select the audio file extensions one time, so everything is selected. With this one we're gonna do the same. That means every audio and video codec available there will be installed. And you can see this is version 13 and there's no spyware or whatsoever in it. Okay, and this is the Mega Codec Pack. If you're on XP, you will need the 995, version 995. So officially this became the 432 player, because on XP the other one is, in fact I should change names, this one should be called 432 Hertz and the other should be called 440. You see, we installed many things while we're also installing the pack at the same time. This is called multitasking, real multitasking. Windows multitasking, my friends. This is beautiful to look at. We are so blessed that we can, you know, download all this software from the internet. It's really a blessing for computer users. Okay, the setup is done. There we are. Let me see if I have it already here. Virtual DJ. Exa. This is 6.1. This is very old. Let's get the newer version, but I think I'm gonna go for version 6 or 7. We hit the download here, download virtual DJ. And then you must scroll a little bit down and then you're gonna find version 7 as well. You go for the home, save, 36 megabytes. Alrighty, now I need to stick. There's the stick. Let's delete some files. For instance, these two files here. These are no good. Delete. What are the big files? Audacity. No. This is gonna stay. We have bigger files. Windows 10 transformation. Sys 64 32. These are tools that I need. I don't want to delete that. Balkan Reggae, I already have that one. Access update, I already have that one. I copied them already to my computer, so I have these songs all. So I can clear some space on this. This USB stick. Okay, though, we go to downloads, virtual DJ, we copy it to the USB stick. Meanwhile, we're looking at the installer of the 10, and a friend also left a reply about a skin pack that he used for his Windows XP, and I'm surely gonna take a look into that very soon. Although I find it really challenging to give these old devices the kind of new look and feels, at least if it comes up to icons, you know. I think that looks really cool, so that's why I'm loving this these skin packs, and that's the only reason why I do that. I'm sure there will not be a skin pack for Windows 98, otherwise we could start soon with this little Windows 98 James Bond laptop that I also have. The one from 1999. The first Windows 98 computer laptop. Handheld laptop. It played in the video A View to a Kill. Eh? I think it was from James Bond. Hey, come on, USB stick. What is wrong with you? Why are you not coming up? Are we having a problem here, ladies and gentlemen? It was coming up, but it was a little bit busy with other things, I think. Wow, this is really amazing, yo peeps. Check this out. I just fixed this look and feels. This is effect my 432 player, and I'm really happy with it because now it's set to play everything on the 432, and I'm listening to songs that effect I didn't like, and suddenly I kind of like them. I'm hearing the words even better, and it's like the voices are more natural. Yeah, So it's really having something, this whole 432 thing. There is also another setting, but we're gonna talk about that in another video. Okay, so there is our system. So how is Virtual DJ working? That's the big question. Here we're gonna put our icons of the full bar and the Virtual DJ, because that is effect what this thing will do. It's gonna play music, and I'm just gonna scroll through the music by mixing them. So you won't really hear the complete song, otherwise I get in trouble, and I don't need that. You understand? Okay, there is Virtual DJ. I have some songs, I think, on my desktop here. Here I see some songs. I want this thing all the way to the top. Okay, though. My playlist, this is my record list, so I'm gonna take everything, Control A, and just pop it in there. Okay, up here I just say mix now. It's very slow with reading the Control A, right mouse click. But in fact, I don't want to do it that way. But how will our BPM player of Alcatech run on this thing? Only thing we can do is let's start it up and find out. Version 4.910. It's loading all the files now.
Game of Apple. Geen wifi in de club. geen wifi in de club. Laat me pony doen loco. Die bitch is gek. Meestal zegt ze niks op weg. Wil ze dat ik er binnen zit.
Bitch, naar keizer, ik noemde Serena Williams. Bitch, ik kom met dame.
Por el trato aquel, siempre dat in mi mente, aunque por lo peces.
Je weet al die track, misschien wel, hè?
Misschien wel, hè?
Je hoort het de hele dag in de klaar.
I think it's really nice on the BPM player. Just like on the Pentium 2. And yesterday I found out that we have a recorder so we can record. That's also kind of cool.
Ik had een idee, bro. Ik werd wakker vanochtend en ik dacht, ze is spijker en niks in de kippen. Zo een remix.
You see, when I click the fade, it automatically goes to the other player. And it's always good, the mix is always good. Everybody can mix with this well mix. Can fade the song because the computer is doing the fading for you. So you don't have to worry, even if your name is Adam Curry. The FUBAR 2000. Because I already inserted the clip, the 432 settings, it will play every song in 432. Okay, so we just heard the song called Ik Was Al Binnen. It's one of my favorite songs. This one. This is at 432 hertz. You see, so this it got a complete new sound, and I'm really loving it. And let me show you something. I inserted some plugins, so I can also mix. I can use this as a mixer. You see? I can easily click any song I want and the mix is always good. So, I'm not gonna play all these songs because I have a lot. Sounds are amazing. I want to hear this on a good PA, and in no way this is stuttering or giving any disturbances. So In fact, this is, I think, a very nice player, you know. If you just want to play some songs and you just want to select some songs, you could even DJ with this thing. Sure, that's what I think. Only thing you must do is click a song and then go party with the people. Make pictures of the people, you know, and enjoy with the people. It's about the music you play. It's not about the actions and the headphones that you're wearing when you're standing behind your DJ thing. It's not about that, man. It's about enjoying with the people. Okay, so up here we can take one more look at playback. The DSP manager. Here you see crossfader. We also have a crossfader, and here we can set the crossfading time. I like to put it at 300, and 3312 is just fine. So you can also downmix channels, equalizer here, move stereo to rear channels, etc. I'm not gonna do any of that. Okie doke. So what I'm now gonna show you is, if you go to view and then to layout and then to quick setup up here, you can change the look and feels. You see that? Now the text, you see the colors, blue. You see now it's blue, if you like that. Blue, gray with pink. I think this is nice for a girl. This is nice for guys. Dark orange. This is nice. This is beautiful. Look at all these, you know, olive, orange, on King's Day, Kitty, gray, orange. I think gray, orange looks really nice. We also have yellow. That is hurting your eyes. This is, wow, look at that. Also nice, but kind of eye hurting. Vintage, this is vintage. Winamp style, you see that? System default. Pastel green. No, I think orange is this one here. It's the very, no, not this one. Gray orange. I think I like this. This looks nice. You see that? And then also the thingy here. That's orange. You see that? And I think you can also change these things around. These windows. I'm not sure. You can make them bigger or smaller. Like this. You see? And all music. This is all music. Selection properties. Nothing selected. So you must go and play with this to understand this even better, okay? But I really advise it. It's a very nice piece of software, especially because you can play all your songs without doing any other setting. You can play them in 432, okay? I'm gonna show you one more time how to do that. You must copy the DLL file to the folder, as I showed you in the beginning of the video. Otherwise, rewind and go watch the video completely. And up here in SoundTouch configuration, you double click SoundTouch here, then it comes here, and then you can configure it. And you just select pitch adjust, okay? Not the tempo, but the pitch, just the pitch. And then you set it to 1.81 semitones. That's it. Then you're done. Then all your songs will play minus 1.81 semitones. Capis? Good. Next, videos. How is this thing playing videos? Well, if the Pentium 2 can do it, I think I have a bigger challenge for this device. And that is hey, where's the USB? We need the USB. And that is an MP4 file that was downloaded from YouTube. Same concept. Of 30 minutes that you saw in the previous video. Hold on a second. I must load this thing here. There it is. Continue without scanning. No, 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 not run setup. Are you crazy? No. What are you doing? This thing is not to run Windows 7 or Windows 10. No, not install Windows. Are you out of your mind? Go away. So, I have an MP4 file here. And it should be a big file, so I'm gonna select on size here. You probably can't see crap, Dirkus. And it's the MP4 file of... Hey, where is it? Oh, I deleted it. I deleted it. Well, I still have Loopy-Doo. But that is a WMV file. Of course, that will play good on here. Even from the USB stick, it will play just fine. But I think you can also play MP4 files. But unfortunately, I have no MP4 file here at this moment. We started this journey around, what was it, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, maybe it was 5. We did a paint job and we installed a complete new operating system on this thing, and we tried attempt to make a perfect DJ machine from this jewel number, what was it, I can't even remember, the N something. But we find out that virtual DJ is not running too good. BPM player is running way better, so I'm kind of happy with the BPM player on this machine. Works fine. The FUBAR 2000 finally gave me what I was searching in the other one, but because of the light system that we installed, the XP light, the FUBAR is not working too good. It needs a good working full version of XP, I think, and then it will work just fine. So FUBAR is nice, because FUBAR will let me play all my music in 432 or even in, you know, any other frequency that I would love to hear it. It has the fading plug-in, so I can fade the songs also on Seek. You can insert that. We can change the theme of the look and feels. So that is really kind of cool, I think. FUBAR 2000 is very nice software. Maybe I should make a special review about it, and to get even more people to, you know, listen to 432 Hz music, because it's really relaxing. And even the songs that I listened and played these last weekends, when I was, you know, DJing these songs, sound different to me, and I'm kind of listening even better and understanding even better what they are saying in the song. So in some way you start listening, so that is a good thing, right, for your brains. All right, video, I don't find video is playing good on this thing. This thing is totally not a video player. Maybe it is, but on the XP, on the Vista, I think Vista is too heavy. I think the best operating system on this thing should be, I think, also for the temperature. The fan is in fact running 24/7. So I think XP Lite, a light version, would be even better. Or maybe a full version or a medium light version that will let FUBAR work. But in fact, I'm not planning to kill that system anymore. I just like it the way we made it yesterday. So it's gonna stay just like that. It doesn't have to play in 432 Hz. If I want to play 432 Hz songs, I just, you know, copy the ones that I created, converted straight up to the thing. It's just fine. Well, more I don't have to say. We can take a last look at the paint job.
Maybe you can see it there. It looks like new. It was very scratched, this laptop, but now it looks really nice. So after this long journey with the dual laptop that became a DJ laptop, nothing more, it became a perfect 432 Hz player. That is what it became. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Have a nice weekend and love to see you in my next video again. Thank you for watching.